show me in the Bible where it says repent of your sins.
Wait, telling people not to repent of their sins. Hey. You want a gospel that's sinful.
Hey everyone, I just want to make a quick video in regards to this heretic street preacher by a guy named David Lynn in Toronto. I made a video in the past, but my YouTube channel got deleted, so I just want to make a quick video, make some comments on it. Thank you.
Anyway, this guy preaches repent of your sins. He preaches to be saved, you have to repent of your sins. Show me in the Bible where it says repent of your sins. He adds the magical word of your sins. The Bible says repent.
So you want a platform, sir? You want?
Amen. You don't have to repent of your sins to go to heaven. It's a free gift.
A platform.
Hey, I can preach too, can I? I gotta rebuke you. You're a false prophet. This guy comes and preaches damnable heresy that'll send you to hell. I'm a Christian. How are you guys gonna treat me? I believe in the Lord Jesus Christ. I believe in him for salvation. I don't trust in my own righteousness.
Why are you making satanic signs, man, with your fingers, bro?
Okay, sure. I don't trust in my own works and repenting of my sins to get to heaven. You don't want to listen to me?
No, I don't.
But you want
because
to
you're not talking to me. You're preaching. Okay. If you want to preach, go set up and preach.
You just listen to these guys for 20 minutes.
Do you want to have a dialogue minutes? Or do you want to preach? Okay. So I don't need your doctrine. If you want to ask me a question.
Show me where it says repent of your sins, not repent.
If you want to ask me a question.
Go ahead. Show me in the King James.
Okay, sure.
You don't have a Bible?
No, I don't. It's over there.
Don't touch my Bible. Go grab your own. COVID going on.
You're afraid of COVID and you're a Christian.
Hey.
So this guy, David Lynn, he goes a street preach without a Bible. I mean, regardless whether he's a false prophet or not, you would think someone who wants to go preach to someone would bring at least Bible with him.
Point the camera at me. He's here preaching. Right. He doesn't have a Bible.
This guy doesn't want the word. I'll get out of the Bible.
Gospel. The Bible says in Romans 3:10, says, as it is written, there's none righteous, no, not one. It says right in verse 23, for all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. What does that say? Everybody sins. Everybody comes short of the glory of God. Okay? What does it say right here? What does it say in 1 John?
Are you God?
What does it say in 1 John? If we say that we have no sin, we deceive ourselves and the truth is not in us. What does that say? We all sin, okay? We're all sinners. There's a flesh, we struggle with our flesh.
Yeah, I know that.
There's a spiritual body. Step back, please. There's a spiritual body. We struggle with our flesh and our spirit. That's what the Bible talks about. So every day when you wake up and your body says, or your mind says, wake up. But your body says, no, lay down for another 10 minutes. Or when you want to eat something, but your mind says, don't eat that, it's not good for you. But your body does it anyway. That's the flesh and the spirit struggling against one another. Once you get saved, you still have that man. You have to put him away every day and read your Bible so that you try not to sin. You should try not to sin. But repenting of your sins has nothing to do with going to heaven. Okay? So what's the Bible say? In Revelation. It says in Revelation 21.
Proverbs 28:13. He that covers his sins shall not prosper, but he who confesses and forsakes his sins shall have mercy. Here's one verse.
I'm just going to rebuke you and I'll leave.
Okay. He asked me for a verse. I give the guy a verse. Do you want the verse or no?
Do you want to hear what I have to say? Do you want to hear the gospel? And then you can rebuke me after I leave. You can dispute anything I say.
Who are you, dude?
My name's Jesse.
Jesse, who cares?
I'm a child of God.
Who cares? I don't believe that. You wouldn't interrupt a preacher if you were a child of God.
You're not a preacher.
You're not a preacher. You're telling people not to repent of their sins. You want a gospel that's sinful.
Well, I'm glad that he thinks the gospel, the good news, is sinful. The fact that Jesus died for our sins, he rose again for our sins, and is a free gift, that's sinful. You know, that what he said will condemn him on Judgment Day.
And Jesus says that he is not a sinful God. Be ye holy as the Lord our God is holy. You don't want a holy God. You want a sinful God, and I don't believe in you. Proverbs 28:13. He that covers his sins shall not prosper, but whoever confesses and forsakes his sins shall have mercy. This is the word of the Lord. There's many other passages that I'm going to bring up. Hallelujah.
False prophets, they always use verses in the Bible that have nothing to do with salvation and apply that to salvation. So for example, in John chapter 8, when it says go and sin no more, oh, Jesus still needs to go sin no more. And now this guy's using the book of Proverbs. He that confess and forsake shall have mercy. Yeah, amen. But that's talking about physical in this earth. It is not even talking about spiritual salvation.
We've come to a day that people don't believe in repentance of sins.
I believe you should repent of your sins.
You believe now he believes that you should repent of your sins.
This guy can't make the
okay, so how about this? Don't repent of your sins and you're going to go to heaven. Just live in sin.
Hey,
is that what you believe?
If I live in sin, I'll get punished by this earth.
You'll get punished. No, you're not saved if you live in sin.
Let's hear that again, shall we?
You'll get punished. No, you're not saved if you live in sin.
So if we live in sin, then we're not saved? Well, everybody lives in sin. People always talk about the big sins like fornication, drugs, alcohol, partying, all the pornography, all these big sins. But people don't talk about the smaller sins like lust, covetousness, getting angry without a cause, and saying stupid words. Or what about when the Bible says, don't boast about tomorrow? We're supposed to say, if God is willing, then we do this. To him that knoweth good and doeth not, to him it is a sin. So clearly, we all live in sin. So according to his standard, we none of us are saved. But this guy, David Lynn, he's a hypocrite. He's no different than Pharisees. He's a very seem righteous on the outside, but inside he's full of dead man bones, a heretic, and he's a hypocrite that looks down on the publicans. That's who he is.
The Bible says God chastens and chastises every son whom he receiveth.
Okay.
What does that mean? He will punish you.
Does God want you to repent of your sins? Yes or no? Does God want you to repent of your sins?
Could come and kill me. That's legally punished. I can go to jail for the rest of my life. That's punishment on this earth. That has nothing to do with going to heaven. If I accept in the Lord Jesus Christ, so who's saved? Him or me? I believe in the Lord Jesus Christ with all my heart. All my faith. I'm not relying on my own works and repenting of my sins. That's what he said you have to do to go to heaven. He just said you have to repent of your sins. Listen to his preaching. Type in YouTube.
Alright, I'm gonna read the scripture real quick.
This is a scripture that just disputes what you're saying. 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verses 9 and 10. It says, or do you not know that the unrighteous will not inherit the kingdom of God? Do not be deceived. Neither the sexually immoral, nor idolaters, nor adulterers, nor men who practice homosexuality, nor thieves, nor the greedy, nor drunkards, nor revilers, nor swindlers will inherit the kingdom of God.
It's the goodness. Repentance from what? Their sins.
Unbelief.
Okay, so I'm going to entertain this guy who believes it's simply unbelief. So if you believe in Jesus Christ, you are turning from your other gods, which is sin. You are turning from your false gods, which is sin. If you turn to Jesus Christ, you're turning your back on sin. No, you're not. How can you turn your heart to Jesus if you don't turn your back on sin?
Buddha, and I have to turn to Jesus.
So how about this?
I can never stop sinning.
So I can still believe in Allah and have Jesus as my Savior? I can still believe in Buddha and have Jesus as my Savior? Can I still worship that God and have this God as my Savior? You see, that's right. Can I still believe in Buddha and have Jesus as my Savior? But I thought I don't have to repent. I just have to believe in Jesus.
This guy can't make the difference between repent of your sins and repent.
Is it a sin to believe in Buddha?
You keep adding the magical word of your sins. It doesn't say.
No, that's a stupid argument because Allah is not the God of the Bible. You have to believe the God of the Bible. You have to, you know, the Bible mentioned that warned us that there will be a false gospel, a false God, and a false spirit. So we need to have the right gospel, the right Jesus, and the right spirit. So, and if you believe in Allah or Buddha or whatever, you basically trust in your own works for salvation. We need to stop doing that. That's called faith. So this guy is twisting words and he's lying. The reason why I want to expose this guy, because on my last YouTube channel, when I exposed this guy at David Lynn, we had 1,000 views, and most of them were so-called Christians who defending this guy. There was a video where David Lynn said that, oh, if you baptize, you wash away your sins. That's heresy. And people don't realize it. So I just want to expose this guy and just check out this video. This guy literally thinks that if you're born again, you will not sin again. So I get this guy must be better than the Apostle Paul, the Apostle Peter, or any other apostle. This guy is a heretic, a Pharisee. He's so blinded. God blinded his eyes so much that he can't even tell he's a sinner. That's how arrogant he is. He's going to die and goes to one of the lowest hell for teaching heresy.